what the pandemic has taught me about men. Hi, I'm Ed Riggins, but most people just call me Riggo, and welcome back to Thoughts for Thursday. A few months ago, the Washington Post ran an article that talked about male friendships. Because I've worked hard at it, I went into this difficult period as a guy who already had several deep male friendships. It's not an exaggeration to say that these connections have saved my sanity. Jeffrey Greif is quoted in the article, and he wrote a book about male friendships called Buddy System. Greif said this, "The rules for guys pursuing other guys for friendships are not clear. Guys don't want to seem too needy," close quote. That brother's laying down some truth. Niobe Way is a professor of developmental psychology at NYU. She's also quoted in the article. "The lack of vulnerability in male friendships is rooted in a misogynistic, homophobic culture that discourages emotional intimacy between men. But it's also part of a culture that does not value adult friendship in general," close quote. We're not at church, but to that I just got to say amen. So here's how it goes for me. I'll call a guy, or he calls me. He asks, "How's it going, Riggo?" I'll say something like, "I'm at about an 8.5 on a 10 scale on a COVID-adjusted basis, but on an absolute basis, I'm probably at a 6. That usually gets a laugh, but it also opens up a space for us to have a real conversation. If I'm really at a 6, it's probably because of the very real human emotions of fear or sadness, and these are not easily discussed among men. I might ease into things by saying something like, "I'm really nervous about so-and-so." Nervous is a euphemism for fear, and it's an easier word for me to say and for him to hear from another man. Or I might say, "I'm really bummed about so-and-so." Bummed is a euphemism for sadness, and sadness is not an easy emotion for men to deal with, even in private. When it's my turn to tune into the other person, I remember that we dudes have been conditioned to try to fix things that are broken. But I set that urge aside and just listen. I've come to realize that periods of silence create a new context for communication. I could care less who won the game, but I care deeply about the challenges of kids having to be away from school, or family illnesses, or breakups, or weddings that had to be postponed, or job losses. This is the real stuff that real friends talk about. Please keep an eye out for an email about my new group career coaching program, and let me know if you want to be put on the early bird list. Thanks for joining me.
Doors closing.